I'm your friend, Dr. Charles Apoki, and I'm doing a video from a holiday resort somewhere in Delta State. I came here with my granddaughter and my daughter, and I want to start a series of lectures on the power of womanhood. One of the things that we must know is that womanhood was a deliberate creation of God. We must realize that until we know and understand womanhood, humanity will not be complete. Humanity stands on four legs: two legs for the males, two legs for the females. The table of humanity is made strong and stable by the two legs of the woman, the two legs of the man. Let me use male and female. The average female, you see, out of 250 million sperm cells that her father ejaculated, she was the first among the 250 million sperm cells. That is, the population of America was released at the cervix by the father during copulation, and she came first. She ran and overtook every other X chromosome, overtook every other Y chromosome, and fertilized the X chromosome of the mother. Because males have Y chromosomes, females have X chromosomes, so a male is XY chromosome, a female is XX chromosome. For that X chromosome to have outrun 250 million Y chromosomes, or a mixture of 250 million Y chromosomes and X chromosomes, she must be a winner. She must be a champion. She must be extraordinary. And a woman must be looked at from that perspective, that all her potential brothers, she was better than them the day she fertilized her mother's Y chromosome. And for her to swim from the cervix to the fallopian tube, by mathematical extrapolation, vis-a-vis the current size of an adult, it's like a man or a woman swimming from Lagos to New York across the Atlantic. And with the peristaltic, the waves, the contractive waves of the womb and the fallopian tube, she must have overcome so many obstacles in life that she cannot be deemed to be a failure. She's not a sex object. Neither is she only a baby factory or a milk industry. She's not a model. She's not an appendage. She's an asset. She's a survivor. A female should be seen in that perspective. Our wives should be seen in that perspective. Our daughters should be seen in that perspective. Our neighbors who are females, our classmates who are females, should be seen in that perspective. Some of the best students in my class were females. And I can name a lot of females, from Queen Nzagi of Angola that defeated the Portuguese at war, to Princess Teitu, the Queen of Ethiopia, that named Addis Ababa, that led a platoon to war against the Italians in the Battle of Adowa, where Ethiopia defeated Italy at war. I can name Golda Meir of Israel that defeated the Arab nations that came against her in the Yom Kippur War. I can name Queen Amina of Zaria. I can name Emota of Benin. I can name Fela's mother, Mrs. Fumilayo Anikulapokuti. And I can name Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala. I can name Angela Merkel. Until we start seeing women as assets, women as pillars, say our daughters shall be like pillars carved to adorn palaces. I can also name my wife, Mrs. Apoki Felicia. And when you see women as assets, and see them as strength, and see them as winners, you will not rape them, you will not kill them, you will not see them as cooks and cleaners only. You will see them as people with inherent ability to excel and to exceed even their male counterparts if equal opportunities are given to them. I shall be doing a series on womanhood, the power of womanhood. I and then we will learn more about womanhood. God bless you. I remain your friend, Dr. Charles Apoki. If you are a woman and you see this video, please share it to as many males as possible. God bless you.